Have you heard of configuration as code? Did you know that you can centralize all your configs in one place? Today, I'll show you a really exciting tool called Configu. Stay tuned as I demo a real-world use case for you. So this will be an introduction to Configu. What we're going to do today is we're going to talk about what Configu is and why Configu, why use it in the first place. I'll show you a quick start just to get you started, and then we're going to run a demo for building a monitoring stack with Prometheus, Grafana, and Loki. So what is Configu? It is configuration as code. So similar to infrastructure as code that we talk about all the time, this is configuration as code. And it is an open source software, and it's used for streamlining, testing, and automating applications, the configurations for those applications across environments. So why would you use Configu? There are multiple reasons. One of them is to centralize all your configuration in one place. That obviously increases your visibility across your teams, so they know what configuration has been used in development versus production versus staging and testing. And it's really, really helpful. If you're anything like me, I have configuration running in .env files for applications in GitHub repos or GitLab repos. I have others for Terraform running also in other repos. I have some config running for Kubernetes, maybe in kubeconfig files, for example. So all that is scattered all over the place, and that's just one user. Can you imagine an entire department or multiple teams? Everybody has their own configuration sitting somewhere. So very helpful to centralize it all. Of course, this reduces human error. And exporting is a really neat feature because you can export this config in multiple formats. And you'll see in just a little bit how we can export in things like a kubeconfig file, a Terraform tfvars file, and more. And then, of course, RBAC for team. You want to make sure you know who has access to what kind of configuration and where. So in our quick start, we're going to install Configu. We're going to see an example schema file, what that looks like. We're going to log into the SAS, and then we're going to set some values and retrieve values in multiple formats. Okay, so then why don't we get started with that? I'm going to jump into my Visual Studio Code here, and I'm inside the intro folder, and I have a nice README file for us that we can go through. So first off, we're going to install. I'm installing here on Linux, so it's this curl script. Of course, you would probably want to take a look at the script before doing what I'm doing, but I have looked at it already. I trust it. So this has already installed Configu for me. And if I just run Configu, I can see the version it's running and everything else. So that's great. Let's clear out of here. And let's start off with this getting started Configu init command. What this is going to do is going to create a file for me here. And this file is the schema file that we have here. It's in the format cfgu or configu.json file. And as you can see here, I've got three configurations that I can use. So I've got a greeting. It's of type regular expression. It has all these patterns and it has a default value of hello. I have another one, subject. It's of type string and a default value of world. And I have another one called message, which is of type string. And this one has a template. So you can actually use the greeting from up here, comma, the subject from here with an exclamation mark. And this will be our message, and a description here generates a full greeting message. So that's great. Okay, what else do we have? Next, we want to log in to the SAS backend. And Configu is, again, an open source. There are multiple backends that you could use. You can use things like Vault, HashiCorp Vault, for example, Secrets Manager. These are secrets backends. There are other multiple backends that we'll take a look at later. But here, Configu will allow us to log into the SAS backend. Let me show you what that looks like. So we get this confirmation here on this screen. And it says, just make sure that these numbers or this code is the same. It is, so we can confirm that. And once that's confirmed, we're all set to go. So let's go back to our CLI, and my organization here is TechInAid. I've already signed up for the SaaS backend. Of course, you can go ahead and do that if you go to configu.com. And we can see here how if you go into login, you'll be able to create a new account. And of course, I'm already logged in. So we'll keep that on the side here. One other thing I wanted to show you as well is if you go to their documentation, and feel free to go through the concepts, of course. Here's their Configu Cloud, CLI, SDK, and so on. And if you go to the config store, here you can see all the available stores. So you've got Configu itself, the SaaS, you've got in memory, so you can store in memory. Of course, you probably won't do that. You can store in a file, a JSON file, any file. You got Launch Darkly, HashiCorp Vault as a secret manager, AWS secret manager, Azure Key Vault, GCP secret manager. You can store as a Kubernetes secret, AWS parameter store, KeyV, SQLite, MySQL, MariaDB, Postgres, CockroachDB, and so on. So we've got multiple backends, if you will. We call them config stores. And for, again, today, we're just going to go with Configu as the backend. They have a generous free version that you can run with, and that's what we're doing today. Awesome. All right, so going back to our example, I've selected my default organization, which is TechInAid, and now I'm going to start to put some values into my store. So we use this Configu upsert command. And here we have to specify the store that I'm using, and that's Configu. I'm using a config set called staging. And I'm also using a schema file, which is that same schema file we just saw before here. So I'm using that schema file, and I'm adding this value of greeting equals to bonjour. Okay, so equals to bonjour. It's one of the available patterns for me, so this will be accepted. Perfect. Let's hit enter. So it config upserted successfully. I was able to upload my configuration successfully. Of course, you can do this through the UI, through the API. I'm just doing it here through the CLI. Another value I can put in here, and this one goes to a different config set called QA. And I'm using the same schema, and I am pushing the subject equals to Sam. All right, so I've added those successfully. If I go back and take a look at what happened, I can take a look at my QA. And in QA, I can see here, show the value is Sam. It says 28 minutes ago because I did this just before the recording. Since nothing changed, it's still the same value here for QA for subject Sam. I can go back to my config sets, look at staging. Same thing here. I can show the value for greeting is bonjour. Wonderful. So we were able to put values into our config sets. Now we want to export these values, right? So later on, we might want to export those values. It could be a different persona. Maybe a developer now needs to grab this information, this configuration, to put them in their development environment in an application or something. So here we use the export command to fetch and validate configurations. So in this case, we're going to use this configu eval and pipe it to a configu export. So we're looking at, again, the store is configu, the schema is the config set is QA, schema is the same schema we've been using. And the format we're going to export is a JSON format. We're dropping it into this file, greeting.json. Hit enter. And here we go. We've got our configuration in a JSON format. Greeting, hello. Subject, Sam. Message is hello, Sam. Okay. And now let's do the next one. And the next one is an env file. So let's drop our configuration as a .env file. So very similar to what we did before, but this time the format is .env. We get a .env with the proper format that a .env file would expect, as you can see. The next one is a Kubernetes config map file. So I can do the same thing. I can drop in here, config map file. It gets created for me, a kube config map. As you can see, the data here, greeting, subject, message, all in the proper format. And finally, a terraform.tf vars file, which we'll use in our real world case demo in just a few minutes. So we've done the same thing here in the format terraform.tf vars. And I can see my file for terraform.tf vars is in the expected format to use with Terraform. Wonderful. All right, so that was really a short intro into Configu, but of course you'd have so many questions in your mind right now, and in your wheels are spinning in your mind as how you can use Configu in your own applications, in your own environment. So with that, let's go ahead and take a look at what we're going to build for our real world scenario. And what we have is GitHub as our version control system. We're going to use GitHub Actions for our CI/CD pipeline. We are going to use Configu as our configuration store for configuration as code. And we're going to interact between GitHub Actions and Configu, inputting, outputting values, and so on. So we'll see that in the demo as we go along. Of course, Terraform is going to be used to provision our infrastructure. GitHub Actions will call on Terraform. It's going to use Terraform Cloud behind the scenes just to store our state file consistently. And Terraform is going to go ahead and create an AWS VPC, subnets, all the necessary networking, plus an EC2 instance. And we'll see what happens in EC2 instance in just a bit. But just know that we will create development and production environments, and all the config will be stored in Configu and called upon Configu through GitHub Actions. Again, depending on whether we want a development environment or a production environment. What happens next is GitHub Actions is going to call on Ansible, and Ansible is going to go ahead and set up and create a Docker Compose environment. So it's going to spin up a Prometheus, Grafana, Loki containers, multiple containers that are defined in a Docker Compose file. So Ansible will deploy all that for us and we'll be good to go. So let's go ahead and jump right into our demo. So back to Visual Studio Code. Let's clear out of here and let's close all of this. And as you see here, we've got a few folders. I've got a folder for Terraform, a folder for our monitoring stack where we got a Docker Compose file, and I got a folder for Ansible. In addition to all of that, I've got a couple of workflow files, one for deploying and one for destroying. And I've also have our schema, Configu schema, which I want to show you right now. And this Configu schema has multiple values here. So we've got a prefix that we will use with Terraform. I've got a region. This is of type AWS region with a default of US East 1. I have an address space. It has a pattern, so we can see a CIDR block, as you can see here. I have a subnet prefix, an instance type, default T2 micro, my AWS key, and an IP that we're going to use for our EC2 instance to view our Grafana Prometheus applications. Okay, so that is wonderful. It's great. What we need to do is basically, first off, is we need to make sure that we have our environment set up ahead of time in Configu. So let's take a look now at our environment. And the first thing we need to do is set up our environment variables or our variables in Configu for both the development environment and production environment. So I'm going to grab this and I'm going to paste it as is right here. And just make sure that I'm in the right directory. Okay, I was in the wrong directory. So let's paste that once again. And configuration upserted successfully. And just to show you what we did, we basically are using our config set development monitoring with our schema that I just showed you. And there I'm putting in a bunch of values for my variables, okay? So this is for development, and now I'm going to do the same thing, but this time for production, right? And what I did now is basically I'm all set to go to start running my workflows. But first, let's go ahead and take a look at what happened here. So in Configu, if I go back to my sets, I go to development, and actually sets development monitoring, I can see all these values. For example, the region here for development, I just inserted it from the terminal. Okay, so that looks good. Now what I need to do is get my GitHub actions for my workflow to work. So let's pull that over here. All right. And you go to actions, and I have two workflow actions. So I'm going to select my monitoring stack, and I'm going to run the workflow, and I can choose between production and development. So we'll do one at a time. So I'm going to run development, and now I'm going to run production. All right. As you can see, I've been running this before. And if you really look, you can see all the errors. And this is typical when you're running workflows. Look at all the errors that I've been going through and struggling with, right? So don't be discouraged if your workflows don't work, if your pipeline doesn't work. This is normal. If you're starting off in DevOps, very, very normal that you're going to go back and forth to update, fix things. And you'll have a lot more red than you'll have green. But once you have the green color, you'll be very happy and very proud of yourself. These workflows are going to take a little bit of time because, again, it's going to deploy the EC2 instance with Terraform, and then Ansible will go ahead and develop or create our application, and everything will get pulled from Configu. Let me walk you through all of this while this continues to work. So what we've got here is basically we have our workflow, and this is the first workflow. Yeah, really, GitHub Actions is the brain behind the whole operation. And I'm going to walk you through this real quick. So we have a workflow dispatch, and we've got two inputs, as we saw, production or development. That's how we kick off the workflow. In here, we're calling on Ubuntu, and we're setting our Configu organization and Configu token to be able to talk to the Configu SaaS. And that is all defined inside of GitHub secrets. So if you go to GitHub secrets, we have, while this is running, of course, we can go to our settings, and under secrets and variables, you can go to actions. And under here, you can see we've defined Configu org, Configu token, Terraform token, and so on. So these tokens are what we're going to use really to connect to the different pieces in our environment. So if we go back now to our flow, our workflow, you can see that we're running also the app Terraform Cloud token right here. And the steps now, we're checking out the code, the repo here, and we are setting up Configu as a GitHub action. And this was provided in the documentation, so I took it as it is. So we're setting it up, and then we're exporting, this is very important, the configuration for development. So what's happening is if the input is development, then we're running Configu eval, just as I showed you before from the terminal, and we're looking at the development monitoring config set with the same schema, and the format is Terraform TF vars. I'm dropping it into the var.auto.tfvars file. So that's going to populate my tfvars file. That's going to allow us to feed in the variables from Configu into Terraform. So the same thing happens if we're in production. This time we're going to call on the production set for monitoring. And you can see how easy it is to have development in production. You can have multiple environments, staging, QA, and so on. And then you can pull all the configuration straight from Configu based on which environment you're running from. Then we're setting up Python, installing Terraform, we're calling on version 1.5.7, initializing Terraform. And while we're initializing Terraform, we're using a backend config, which is based on whether the environment is production or development. And I have two files here, development.hcl and production.hcl. And you can see I have two workspaces, one called monitoring dev for development, and I have one called monitoring prod for production. This is within the TechInnate organization within Terraform Cloud. Okay. And moving forward, we're going to run Terraform apply auto approve. This will generate the or create the EC2 instance with Terraform. Once that's created, we're going to output the private key. We need the private key because we need that to SSH into the machine with Ansible. So we're going to put it in this temp file and change the permissions for that key to be 400. You can't have it too permissive. So we're going to make sure that it's at 400. And then the public IP that we're going to grab from Terraform output, we need this public IP later on because we're going to push that over to Configu. So we want to upload that to Configu so we know what the machine's IP is and we have it centralized, right, in one place. We can then, I was debugging here to see that we correctly got the environment variable in GitHub's environment. And then adding this Terraform IP to Configu, as you can see, once for development or once for production, really depending on whether we're running development or production. And here we're using the upcert command, the store is Configu, here's our set, our config set, same schema. And now we are using this IP value and grabbing that public IP environment variable that we defined up here to upload our IP into Configu. Then we're updating the Ansible inventory with this public IP. So we have an Ansible inventory right here with a placeholder, and I'm just using sed to replace this placeholder with that public IP that we grabbed from Terraform and uploading this into our Ansible inventory. From there, we're installing Ansible and just quickly debugging to see that the Ansible inventory file correctly has my public IP. And then we're going to run our Ansible playbook. So Ansible playbook runs here, and we can take a quick look at the Ansible playbook that is right here. Pretty straightforward. We're installing pip3 and unzip and installing Docker over here. And then we're copying our monitoring stack directory, which is this directory right here, over to the remote machine, the EC2 instance. And from here, we're running Docker compose, and Docker compose is this file over here. It has multiple services. It got Prometheus. It's got Node Exporter, Alert Manager, CA Advisor, and Grafana, also Loki. So this will stand up all these containers into as a Docker compose file, and they'll be ready to go for us. Now to take you really quickly over Terraform, that's straightforward. What we're doing is we're creating a backend remote here, and it's a partial config. As you can see, we're feeding in the workspace, whether it's development or production, through the GitHub Actions workflow. A variable region, again, this will be dependent on Configu, which value we're grabbing, whether it's US East 1 for production, for I believe development, and US West 1 for development. We can see that's here. So US East 1 is for development and US West 1 is for production. So that we're grabbing that from Configu. AWS subnet, same thing. Security groups, we're exposing port 3090. The Grafana runs on 3000 and Prometheus on 9090. Creating an internet gateway, routing table association, AWS EIP for accessing this public IP, and then an AWS instance, a private key, and an AWS key pair. Our variables file here is mimicking the Configu schema, basically. And honestly, I took this and used ChatGPT and gave him an example of a schema. It was able to generate the Configu schema for me much easier than me doing it manually. I just had to tweak a few things here and there. All right, outputs, of course, we have the public IP, a URL, and a private key. We saw that the public IP, we're taking that, feeding it into the Ansible inventory file, and also uploading it into our Configu configuration. All right, and so that's pretty much it. It's pretty straightforward. And again, the brains behind the entire operation is the GitHub Action workflow. And now let's go ahead and see if we have actually completed a run. So let's go back to Actions. And we already have an error. So let's see what the error is. So it seems like, I think the error is for production. Let's see the development stack first and make sure that it's running well. So the job completed successfully. And if I go back and take a look at Configu, I should be able to grab my development IP. So show value right here. So this is my EC2 instance. If I open a new browser, go to 3000, port 3000. I know I've set the username and password for admin and foobar. So that will take me in to Grafana. I can see that I have connections here. Let's see, data sources. I got Loki and Prometheus. Very nice. And I can also explore the data really quickly. So if I use Metric Explorer, for example, and take a look at memory, let's look up memory. I have memory usage bytes, maybe. Let's select that and run the query. And I already see that we are up and running. We're looking at the memory for the different containers that are running within the EC2 instance. So this looks really good. Now let's go back and quickly see what happened to our production environment and why this failed. So let's go in, apply Terraform config. Let's see what happened here. So you can see Terraform is running. Error importing EC2 key pair, invalid key pair duplicate. The key pair already exists. So this is probably because we generated a key pair that is the same as the key pair from development, right? Let's take a look at our Configu here. As you can see, my AWS key value is mykey.pem for development, and for production, it's pretty much the same. So we're gonna have to change that. So let's change that for production, and we can do that via the upsert command once more. So let's go back to our Visual Studio Code, and let's go into our README. Okay, so here's my development, here's my production. Let's just call this prod like that. And we can rerun this again. All right, double check it once more in Configu. Let's see, there you go. A few seconds ago it was updated. Let's just refresh this. There we go, mykey prod pem. So hopefully this will solve our problem here with the prod deployment. So we're gonna rerun this job. And now this time when Configu goes out to grab the key, the MyKey information for AWS, it will grab the proper one or a different one, or it will create a different one so that we don't have this conflict that we just ran into. Because AWS doesn't allow you to have multiple keys of the same name, right? For our SSH, for the ability to SSH, for the ability to SSH into your EC2 instance. Okay, so I'll pause the video until this is ready, and then we'll come back and take a look. All right, so it ran successfully. Now, if you're curious to see the output, you can see here we're setting up Configu CLI. We're exporting the Configu for production. I'm setting up Python, installing Terraform, initializing Terraform with a dynamic backend config for production, applying our Terraform config, and you can see it runs a Terraform plan. Everything looks good. We do have a public IP at the end of it. We're generating our SSH key, permissions for the SSH key, setting the public IP, and pushing the IP address over to Configu right here, and then updating the inventory file with the public IP for Ansible. Ansible is installed, and we can see that the inventory file now has our public IP right here. Perfect. And running Ansible, you can see the different tasks for Ansible. And finally, it's running, deploying the monitoring stack, and all is great. Everything checks out nicely. But what we can do now is go to Configu and make sure we're in production. And let's make sure I refresh this. And from here, we can reveal the public IP, which we saw before. Let's copy that, open a new window, and go to Grafana. And this will be our Grafana for production. Admin, foobar. Once again, we're in. Everything looks good. I have my connections in place. So this is our production environment for our monitoring stack. I forgot to mention that you can also take a look at Prometheus. We exposed that. So you can see Prometheus as well. And you can look at the status of the targets. So Prometheus is running very nicely. So I have my development environment here. I've got my production environment. And we can also take a look at it in the AWS console. So we're in US East 1, North Virginia. If I go to EC2, this should be our development environment. I can see my instance running here, monitoring Configu demo. And if I switch over to US West 1, North California, this should be my monitoring Configu demo right here. And you can see that this is my production environment. Okay. All right. Now to clean up, all you need to do is go back to our workflows, so actions. And then I have a destroy workflow that you can go ahead and run. So we run this workflow and run for development or production. So once for development, this will go ahead and destroy the EC2 instance using Terraform. And that will basically clean up our environment. So do that once for development and now one more time for production. And there we go. It will start and then that should clean up the environment for us. So with that, that concludes our talk today about Configu. I really like it. It centralizes my configuration in one place. I think I'll be using it more often now. I encourage you to go check it out. Check out their open source, check out the backend, the SaaS backend. Again, they have a generous free tier that you can check out. But I really like the concept of configuration as code, centralizing your config in one place, and then retrieving it and using it. So far, I just showed you everything that has to do with DevOps, infrastructure as code, pipelines, and so on. But I didn't even dig into how you'd use this with your application code, which is also a very important use case that I encourage you to look at. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in another video.